Well, thank you very much. Melania and I would like to just welcome you all to the White House, a very special place. One of the great homes and houses anywhere in the world, call it a home or a house. It's one of the greats, very important to all of us. And we're here today to honor the incredible friendship between the United States and Poland and to celebrate our vibrant, thriving, and proud Polish-American community, of which many of you are Polish American. And we are tremendously honored to host President Duda and Mrs. Kornhauser Duda of Poland. And he's a highly respected leader. He's done a fantastic job. You'd be very, very proud of your homeland, your original place. I know so many of you came there and came directly. They are doing really well. So we're very proud of President Duda. And I've just also spent a lot of time having some very productive meetings, good for Poland and good for the United States. The alliance between the United States and Poland is stronger than ever before. And thanks to our U.S. ambassador to Poland, friend of mine for a long time, Georgette Mosbacher. Where's Georgette? Hi, Georgette. Not a very good location, Georgette. I'm surprised at you. That's not like you. But she's done a fantastic job. Another person doing an incredible job is Wilbur Ross, Secretary. Where's Wilbur? Where's Wilbur? Secretary of Commerce. Thank you, Wilbur. Betsy DeVos for joining us. Where's Betsy? Betsy? Hi, Betsy. Hi, Betsy. Education. Along with some terrific people, representatives, powerful but good. Dan Lipinski. Dan? Dan Lipinski. Thank you. Thank you, Dan. Also here today is Lockheed Martin CEO Marilyn Hewson, and we're very glad to tell you that President Duda plans to purchase 32 American-made F-35s, one of the great planes in the world. Where is Marilyn? Hi, Marilyn. Good job, Marilyn. Doing an incredible job. Thank you, Marilyn. Last week, the world commemorated the 75th anniversary of D-Day. That was some day. In that momentous endeavor, Polish and American warriors fought side by side to defend their nations, defeat Nazi regime. That Nazi regime was defeated and strongly defeated. The heroes of D-Day remind us that no power can match the spirit of a free, proud, and sovereign people. They found that out. In August, we will also mark the 75th anniversary of the Warsaw Uprising, when more than 150,000 Polish patriots gave their lives to reclaim their homeland from tyranny. On my trip to Poland two summers ago, and I will never forget it, I was deeply moved to speak at the monument to the Warsaw Uprising. Many of you remember that scene. The people went 10 blocks long. It was like spokes on a wheel. And it went deep, deep, and there were, I guess, I've never seen anything quite like it. Many young Poles ran into the streets and came face to face with the enemy. One such man was Richard Cosby. Richard Cosby. I had no idea, Rita. I've known Rita so long, I had no idea. Who fought for weeks on end, was gravely wounded, and was taken to a Nazi prison camp in Germany. Months later, Richard and other Polish prisoners escaped to the American front. It's a great day for Richard. This evening, we are honored to be joined by Richard Cosby's daughter and a friend of mine for a long time. I had no idea. Huh? That's great. Rita, come up here for a second, Rita. Come up here. And Reed, I have to say, your dad's story fills our hearts with gratitude for the Polish and American patriots who stared down evil. And I want to thank you. I've known her so long. It's so, I just had no idea. I'm very impressed. I'm even more impressed now. Thank you. Thank you very much. Be careful. Thank you. Thank you very much, Reed. Today, we pay tribute to the heroes of the Warsaw Uprising and all of those who fought so courageously in Warsaw and the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising the year before. After the Second World War, the people of Poland endured a decades-long struggle to regain their independence, and it was tough from very oppressive communist rule, and it was oppressive. This month, we commemorate the 40th anniversary of St. John Paul II's first pilgrimage to his beloved homeland as Pope. He loved Poland. With us today is Jerzy Bogdanowicz. Jerzy, where are you? Get over here, Jerzy. Come on. Jerzy grew up in communist Poland. He and a group of fellow students met with the Pope. Was that exciting, Jerzy? Meeting with the Pope? More exciting than meeting with Trump, right? He said, yes, I can't believe it. Thank you. Thank you, Jerzy. Thank you very much. After the Pope's pilgrimage, Jerzy was one of the thousands of students who joined the Solidarity Movement. And Jerzy, we're honored to have you and every Pole who bravely stood for the rights given to us by God. Jerzy, thank you very much. That was great. Rita, thank you very much. For centuries, our nations have been united by shared aspirations and values. We celebrate the role of family in society and the dignity of every human life. We draw inspiration from our heroes and honor from our traditions. We enrich the world through art and exploration and science. We protect our sovereignty, and we understand that law is the cornerstone of liberty. On this very day, June 12th, in 1987, President Ronald Reagan delivered his famous speech in front of Berlin's Brandenburg Gate, right? We remember that day. That was a special day. Soon after, through the strength of American resolve, the faith of freedom-striving nations, and the mighty spirit of the Poles, the brutal reign of communism in Central and Eastern Europe came to a peaceful end. That was a tremendous day. That was a tremendous time. President Duda, we will never forget all that Poland has endured to win back its freedom. The story of your nation will always inspire patriots all around the world. Here in America, Polish Americans have built flourishing communities, industries, schools, and churches in every generation. Polish Americans helped settle the Midwest, and they helped lead the Industrial Revolution. They worked so hard and so smart. The families here today remind us of the countless ways Polish Americans strengthen our nation. You uplift our communities, sustain our heritage, safeguard our freedoms, and defend our great American flag. Thank you. To every Polish American here today and to those around our country, we say thank you, God bless you, and God bless America. Thank you very much. And now I'd like to thank you very much. And now I know so many of you. I didn't know you were all Polish, to be honest with you. Do you hear that, Rita? I'd like to introduce you to now a man who really has done such an incredible job as a leader, respected all over the world, and your country is more respected, I think, than ever before. When you look at what's happened in Poland, it's truly a miracle, and what they've had to go through over the years. It's never been easy for Poland, but this is a great president, and it's an honor to have him and Mrs. Duda at the White House. Thank you very much. Mr. President. Thank you.
Szanowny panie prezydencie, wspaniała, szanowna pierwsza damo Stanów Zjednoczonych, wszyscy dostojni przybyli goście, szanowni państwo.
Distinguished Mr. President, a wonderful distinguished First Lady of the United States of America, all distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen.
Razem z moją małżonką jesteśmy zaszczyceni, że możemy być tutaj w Białym Domu po raz drugi w ciągu 10 miesięcy.
My wife and I are greatly honored and thrilled to be here at the White House for the second time in 10 months.
Chcielibyśmy podziękować naszym wspaniałym gospodarzom, panu prezydentowi Donaldowi Trumpowi oraz jego wspaniałej małżonce, pierwszej damie Stanów Zjednoczonych, pani Melanie Trump. And
we would like to thank our wonderful hosts, President Donald Trump and wonderful First Lady Melania Trump.
Szanowni Państwo, w ubiegłym roku Polska obchodziła setną rocznicę odzyskania niepodległości.
Ladies and gentlemen, last year Poland celebrated the 100th anniversary of regaining independence.
Miliony Polaków, zarówno w Polsce, jak i poza jej granicami, może zwłaszcza tutaj, właśnie w Stanach Zjednoczonych, świętowało ten niezwykle ważny historyczny fakt.
Last year, Poland celebrated the 100th anniversary of regaining independence, and millions of Poles, both at home and abroad, perhaps especially here in the United States, honored that hugely important historic fact.
Panie prezydencie, pierwsza damo, dziękujemy, że uczciliście tę rocznicę z nami zeszłego września tu właśnie, w Białym Domu. Jesteśmy za to ogromnie wdzięczni.
President and First Lady, thank you for celebrating this anniversary with myself and my wife last September here at the White House. We are hugely grateful and honored.
Ale to nie koniec.
But that's not the end.
W tym roku Polska i Stany Zjednoczone obchodzą kolejną wspólną rocznicę.
This year, Poland and the United States remember another common anniversary.
Stulecie nawiązania stosunków dyplomatycznych w 1919 roku.
The 100th anniversary of establishing diplomatic relations in 1919.
Spośród liczących się wówczas na arenie międzynarodowej państw, właśnie Stany Zjednoczone były pierwszym krajem, który uznał na nowo wskrzeszone państwo polskie.
And from among all the countries that back then in 1919 were valuable in the international arena, in the international stage, it was precisely the United States, which was the first great power to recognize the newly restored Polish state.
Cieszy mnie fakt, że jesteśmy tutaj nie tylko po to, aby pamiętać o tej rocznicy, ale również po to, by inwestować w nasze przyszłe relacje.
And I'm happy that we are here today not only to recollect and commemorate those anniversaries, but also to invest in our future relations.
Panie prezydencie, jeden z pana poprzedników, 33. prezydent Stanów Zjednoczonych, Harry Truman, powiedział kiedyś: to ludzie tworzą historię, a nie odwrotnie. W czasach, kiedy przywództwo jest słabe lub zupełnie go nie ma, społeczność stoi w miejscu.
Mr. President, one of your predecessors, the 33rd President of the United States, Harry Truman, once said, "Men make history and not the other way around. In periods where there is no leadership, society stands still."
I dalej, postęp następuje, gdy odważni, zręczni przywódcy nie boją się wykorzystać okazji do zmiany stanu rzeczy na lepsze.
And then he continued, "Progress occurs when courageous, skillful leaders seize the opportunity to change things for the better."
I oto jesteśmy. Here we are, Mr. President. Wiele osiągnęliśmy od naszego spotkania we wrześniu 2018 roku.
A lot has been accomplished since we met here in September 2018.
Wypełniliśmy deklarację o strategicznym partnerstwie treścią polityczną, gospodarczą, energetyczną i militarną.
We have filled the Declaration on Strategic Partnership with political, economic, energy and security content.
We wszystkich tych obszarach nasza współpraca została pogłębiona z korzyścią zarówno dla Polski, jak i dla Stanów Zjednoczonych.
In all these areas, our cooperation has been deepened, benefiting both Poland and the United States.
To nie są słowa, to są konkretne efekty.
These are not words, these are concrete effects.
Nasze relacje dwustronne zostały wzmocnione dzięki stałemu odwoływaniu się do wspólnie podzielonych wartości, które są filarami świata euroatlantyckiego.
Our mutual relations have been deepened and strengthened through our reference to shared values, which are the pillars of the transatlantic community.
Wierzę, że stosunki te będą ewoluowały w kierunku prawdziwej przyjaźni między zaangażowanymi i zaufanymi sojusznikami.
I believe that they have evolved toward, they will evolve towards a true friendship between committed and trusted allies.
Szanowny panie prezydencie.
Distinguished Mr. President.
W Polsce mamy świadomość, że jest pan naszym wielkim przyjacielem.
In Poland we know that you are our great friend.
I właśnie w tym miejscu, w Białym Domu, w sercu Stanów Zjednoczonych, chcę bardzo mocno podkreślić, że bardzo doceniamy, panie prezydencie, pańskie relacje z pracowitą i lojalną wobec naszych stosunków amerykańską Polonią.
And it is right here at the White House, that the very heart of the United States, that I would like to take this opportunity and appreciate these relations that you have with the hardworking and loyal Polish Americans.
Spotkałem się z tysiącami jej przedstawicieli w wielu amerykańskich miastach podczas moich wizyt w Stanach Zjednoczonych i zapewniam pana, że uczucie to jest odwzajemnione.
I have met thousands of them in different American cities and I can assure you, Mr. President, that this feeling is mutual.
Dear friends, in 2 days America will celebrate the great anniversary. It will be the day of the birth, the anniversary of the day of the birth of the 45th President of the United States of America, Mr. Donald Trump. Happy birthday, Mr. President. Happy birthday to you. May all your dreams come true, Mr. President.
Mr. President, may this first term of your presidency will be the introduction to the second one. Thank you.